Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are seeing my face for the first time, I am Eddy. I film about lifestyle, health and career, and I'm filming from Nigeria. Please do wait to check out some of my other videos, which are already linked in the description box below, and subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on all the good stuff. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you for staying tuned. Thank you for coming back. So today I'm going to be talking about how you can start your own business with zero naira, which means no capital. Few weeks ago, I made a video about business ideas that you can start with no or low capital. If you've not seen that video, check the description box. I already linked it there. You have to check that out. You have to check out that video. So I listed some business ideas, and from it, I'm going to be talking about one of them deeply today. I'm going to be spilling the tea about that particular business, and it requires no capital. If this is something you would like to watch, then sit back, relax, and join me. With the economy of this country, majority of us, we are running away from poverty. As a full housewife, as a student, as a 9-to-5 worker, we are all trying to buckle up, looking for another means of making money. We are trying to save up money. But we are all trying to like look out for money, and majority of us want to actually go into business, but the only bone of contention is capital and also time. So if your own area of the problem is capital, then you have to watch this video. You can actually start up your business with zero naira, but the first question that I will ask is, do you really want to go into business? Because business is not something that you wake up one day and say, oh, I think I want to go into business. You have to be ready. You have to be business oriented. You have to be ready for troubleshooting. You have to be able to multitask. You have to be open to changes and all that, because even life goes like this. So when you are ready and you know and you are for sure that you are ready to become a business owner, then the next question should be, what do you want to do? Okay, now that I'm ready to be a business owner, the question is, what do I want to do? Let's say I'm this type of person that like air. I can differentiate between a good and a bad air. I can actually identify a good air. But the only problem that I have is capital. And then, what do I do? And that brings us to what dropshipping is. So what is dropshipping? Dropshipping is acts of buying and selling without having to stock up products. Talking of products, in the sense that I'm going to the market, I have the money, 50,000 naira, I'm going to the market, I'm going to buy goods. After buying these goods, I'm putting them inside my house to look for customers to come and buy. That is not what dropshipping is. Dropshipping is you buying and selling without putting that stock in your house, in your shop, or anywhere. So this is how dropshipping works. As a dropshipper, you are an intermediary between a manufacturer or a supplier and the end user. Okay, so let's say I'm a dropshipper. I am going to be in between a manufacturer and the end user. So I'm going to be working with someone that have the goods that is stocked up and someone that needs the goods, and everything and all I need is my phone and internet. I'm sure you have a phone that you're using to watch me and internet. So that is all you need to make this money. Okay, so this is how dropshipping works. As you are going to have to look for a supplier that is selling that particular product that you have in mind, you're going to have to work with your audience. Who are your audience? The people that are around you, or let's say on your social media platform, you've studied the people on your social media platform. Okay, this is what people actually need. This is what I actually know about. Okay, this is what I actually want to sell. In your case, it might not be air, it might be jewelries and all that. Okay, so you have to look for somebody. I'm just going to be calling them supplier. You have to look for a supplier that have all these goods stocked up, and then tell them you want to be their dropshipper. Majority of these people already know about dropshipping, so they already even have an online platform for their dropshippers, and all they do is to drop pictures of available goods, put out the details of the goods and price. So let's say I have a supplier that is selling air for 200,000 naira. And as a dropshipper, I'm going to take the picture of this product with details. I'm going to have to advertise it out to the world, to my people, on my own social media platform. And then getting a customer for it, I can decide to sell mine for 205,000 naira. Getting a customer for it, all I have to do is to send my suppliers 200k to her and retain my 5,000 naira again. Okay, as a dropshipper, one thing you want to do is to look for a reliable, trustworthy and humble supplier. I know a lot of businesses that have gone down because of this kind of supplier they are working with. So you don't want somebody to spoil your business. So you don't want a supplier to tarnish your image, in the sense that if you are buying, sometimes dropshipper don't send goods to the customers directly. Let's say I'm in Abuja and my customer is in Lagos and my supplier is in Ibadan. I can decide to tell the supplier to send the goods directly to Lagos to my customer. Okay, now my customer did not know that the goods is not coming from me. If they are not getting what they want, they will start tagging you, okay, what I ordered versus what I got. And this is actually depreciating your own value as a business owner yourself. So you want to look for a trustworthy, reliable and honest supplier. Another thing that you want to do for your business is to brand your business. So how do you brand your business? You get a name for your business, you then get a logo for it. This logo has to be something that speaks for you, for your business. Let's say I'm into hair and I want to name my hair Eddy's hair. So I'm getting a logo for my hair. This logo has to be something that is preaching what I am doing. And also I have to look for a marketing strategy that is going to be different from every other person's strategy. As a dropshipper, another thing that you want to do is to be considerate with the gain that you add. You have to, when you're working with your supplier, if your supplier is sending you goods for 15,000 naira, you have to look at the market price and compare before you start putting prices out there. Because if you are starting as a dropshipper, you don't want to have, there are a lot of competitions out there. You want your own goods to be unique and the price to also be enticing. So you have to be considerate about the amount, about the gain that you are adding to your product. So why dropshipping? Dropshipping is very important. The advantage of dropshipping is in the aspect of you not having to stock up goods, of you not having to look for capital everywhere, stressing yourself looking for money to start up a business. You can start right away. You have your phone, you have your internet. That is one advantage of dropshipping. You don't have to go to market and buy goods at home and be looking for customers, and at the end of the day you don't get people to buy it. This is always very heartbreaking when you have your money, when you have your money in your room and you're looking at it every day because you don't get customers. At the end of the day, people start to like sell out these goods at a lesser price just because they just want the goods out of the way. As a dropshipper, you don't have to face this kind of problem. Another advantage of dropshipping, you have access to multiple products. As a dropshipper, I can decide to say, okay, I have a supplier that is giving me pictures of air. I'm going to have to look for another one that I'll be working with when it comes to jewelry. I can decide to go into wares and all that. You have access to multiple products. Another advantage of dropshipping is you don't need a shop. You don't have to be paying shop rent. You don't have to be paying for NEPA bill or anything. All you need is your internet and your phone, which you already have. Then you start to make your money. Okay, so one honest advice I'm going to give as a dropshipper is you have to put your finance in order, in the sense that you are saving up money. You're making a gain. Let's say you're making gain of 5,000 naira every day. Try as much as possible to invest in yourself in trying to save up money. So at the end of the year, at the end of the month, you can also start buying goods. You already have your platform, you already have your customers. And then from there, you can also become another person's supplier, dropshipper. You can also start helping people by getting dropshippers for your business. That brings us to the end of this video, guys. Thank you guys for watching. If you've learned one or two things, please let me know in the comment section. Start your dropshipping business right away. Thank you guys for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe. Until next time that you're going to be seeing my face again, stay cool, stay calm and be happy. Bye guys.